Hello everyone, I'm Andreas from Eurovisionfan.com and we are here with
Anna Bergendahl.
Hello Anna.
Hi.
Really glad to have you here. We are in Stockholm with you.
Yes.
How are you today?
I'm good today. Thank you. How are you?
I'm good.
Good.
Thanks a lot. So let's talk a bit about you. You started off at by competing in Idol back in 2008.
Yes.
And then you're a Melody Festival legend. You've competed, this is your fourth time,
yes.
And in your first time back in 2010, you won, you represented Sweden at the Eurovision Song Contest.
Yes.
How have you seen your experience forming you as an artist up to now?
Oh, that's a good question, because I actually started competing in music when I was 12.
Mm-hmm.
It was a TV show in Sweden called Super Troopers.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was only 16 when I was in Idol, mm-hmm. and I was 18 when I did Melody Festivalen the first time. So I think that I've been very influenced by competing in music and being judged in front of millions of viewers, and I think that has affected my self-esteem in both a very positive way and sometimes in a negative way.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Why a negative way?
I think it was hard for me to be so young in this industry and to be on live television, and just being judged is a difficult thing, but at the end of the day, it has brought me just so much joy and so many fans, and so I don't regret anything.
Mm-hmm. So you mean you had lots of things to deal with when
yes.
you were so exposed at such a young age, right?
Yes, absolutely. Just being a teenager on its own is
mm-hmm.
hard, because you're struggling to find out, who am I, what do I want to do,
mm-hmm.
Who do I want to become,
mm-hmm.
and at the same time having that much pressure and media attention was difficult.
Yeah, I see. So when we first discussed at the press conference, you told me that your song Higher Power is part of a trilogy of songs.
Yes.
The other songs are Ashes to Ashes and Kingdom Come,
yes.
right? Cool. Can you tell us a bit more about this?
Yeah, sure. So it's the same songwriting team. It's me, Bobby Gison, and Eric, who wrote all three songs.
Mm-hmm.
And the creative producers behind the numbers are also the same, Dennis and Sign. So we've worked together for years now, and it's a fantastic collaboration where I really feel like I can challenge myself and I can develop as an artist and as a singer. Just working with them as a team has made these three songs a trilogy that I'm really proud of.
Mm-hmm. Nice. So regarding your staging,
yes.
I see you having that nice brown dress with the distinctive hat. You at some point throw it away,
yeah.
You do the bold moves with your hands like we have used to seeing you doing, because these are like signature moves, you know?
Yeah.
And at the background LED screen, we see a horse running. You are on a circular platform.
Yeah.
How does your staging connect with the song?
So, the producers behind the number, Sign and Dennis, they always work from the song and from the lyrics. They themselves listen to a lot of music and love lyrics. So they start with just the feeling that they get from the song, and then just these ideas pop up into their heads. And this time, the first thing that they thought of was horses. They stand for, strength, power, beauty, I think that they are brilliant in connecting the number with the song and enhancing the song to just a higher level. Yeah.
Nice. So outside your artistic profession, you are a doctor.
Yes.
Currently in training, right?
Currently in training, so
okay.
I'm not really a doctor yet.
Okay,
yeah.
Cool. So I guess that your professional life has been affected by the pandemic. How has your artistic and personal life been affected by this?
Yeah, it was so in 2020 I competed with Kingdom Come, and shortly after all of Sweden's music industry and, you know, everything, sports and everything just shut down. So I was ready to go out on a long tour after Kingdom Come. You know, I ended up third in the competition, and, you know, I was thrilled and I was really happy to get to meet my audience, and then I couldn't, and it was a necessary move for the Swedish government, and I totally respect it. But it was difficult. But for me, I could go back to school, to med school, basically, I think 3 weeks after the Melodifestivalen final. So I ended up studying for 2 more years. So I mean, it didn't really affect me that much because I had this other thing that I could do. So yeah.
Nice. So we are currently at the final week of Melodifestivalen.
Yeah.
I can see you are really excited about this. We are so happy to see you qualify. What are your plans for the day of the finals and for the days after?
So on Saturday, I hope that I will be able to just enjoy myself and feel happy, liberated, free, strong on stage, because that's what I want to instill in others. I want to instill hope and light, and if I feel that myself, I believe that I can, you know, transmit it to other people, and we need a lot of that right now. So if I can give the viewers 3 minutes of hope and light, then I will be really happy.
Believe me, you do.
Thank you.
You do.
Thank you.
I love the song and the whole staging and how all these two combine.
Thanks.
So, do you have any of the rest of the 27 songs? Do you have any favorites from them?
I love Cornelia. I think she is the best.
Yeah.
I hope she wins. She's amazing in every single way. So, so yeah, she's my favorite.
Yeah. Nice to hear that. Mine as well. Yeah. It's my favorite.
So I'm not your favorite? I'm just kidding.
You are my favorite, but I mean, you know,
I'm just kidding.
It's what would stand out in terms of the rest of the songs that have been selected already.
Yes.
mean, when I saw Cornelia, it was like boom.
Sure, absolutely.
And you understand that, as we've already discussed, Swedish people vote in a strange way.
Yeah.
And even that is not a sure thing that she will get voted, so...
Sure. I was only kidding.
Yeah, I know. So, any other favorites from the whole Eurovision Song Contest from any other country?
Oh, let's see. I'm not good with names.
You can tell me years or
I'm not good
country.
With years.
Okay.
But I loved Ukraine. What was her name? It was a few years back.
Shady Lady.
No, not Shady Lady. She wore blue, I think.
You mean with 1944?
Yes. Loved her.
Yeah.
And
now Ukraine is in a really difficult situation.
Yes.
Jamala.
Jamala, right.
Jamala,
yes. Right, yeah, I loved her. Let's see, what else?
Let me help you.
Yeah.
Do you know Helena Paparizou?
I love Helena Paparizou, and she, you know, she performs here too, and she speaks Swedish, so I love her.
She won the Eurovision Song Contest in 2005.
Yes.
And she was 2014 in Melodifestivalen.
Right,
Survivor.
And obviously I love Celine Dion. Fly on the Wings of Love, Denmark, 99?
I think so, I'm not sure.
So I have a few favorites.
Cool. Now, before we say goodbye to you, would you like to sing just a bit of the song for us?
Sure,
cool.
Absolutely. I see a higher power rise a spirit larger than life, cutting right through the fire, turning the wind right before my eyes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you
so much for being here with us.
Thank you.
We can't wait to see you this Saturday. I will be seeing you tomorrow at the rehearsals as well.
Great.
And wish you all the best.
Thank you.
The best of luck this year.
Thank you so much, and thank you for your support. I love you guys. Mwah.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Oof.